We had a committee meeting on the future of jobs. We all know how technology is going to destroy jobs, technology is going to reduce jobs, and technology is going to give us new jobs. India has to be prepared for the new jobs that are going to come, and we deliberated upon that. What is sure is, India may be 5 to 10 years behind the United States as regards the impact on technology and jobs, but the job intensity of economic growth is going to come down. If the economy grows at 8%, jobs will grow at 5 to 6%. Tomorrow, if the economy grows at 8%, jobs will grow only 3 to 4%. Jobs will grow in India because we are supply constrained, we are still growing, we need a lot of infrastructure, people's consumption levels are very poor, and they have to only improve. And with our GDP going up from about $2.5 trillion now to $5 trillion by 2025, and maybe $10 trillion by 2030, demand is going to shoot up everywhere else, but automation will reduce the job intensity of economic growth. And that's why we need to be prepared. What we are discussing is that we will look at 4 or 5 kind of new jobs that are going to come, and how we need to train people, put in the training collateral, put in everything else to train people, and the investment that has to be put there, and what are the action agenda. We also said there's a need for a lot of jobs in labor intensive industry. We have to possibly look at labor intensive industries, map them out, see the labor potential, and then look at districts of India where there's a large amount of labor, and possibly create a policy to have labor intensive industries there with decent infrastructure, so the labor doesn't have to be displaced. And this is especially true about women, because women's participation in the workforce is only 24%. We need to pull it up if India has to do well to 50, 60, 70% in the next 5 to 7 years. So we have to get jobs to the place where women are. And we got to find out where a large number of women are coming from the land, are in need of jobs, and possibly put labor intensive jobs there. China did that in a very big way. We know that Foxconn, out of 1.1 million people, had possibly 800,000 young women working, and possibly use the same model. And we also said we need case studies on how companies and others have done good work, skill development companies have done good work, employees have done good work, and place these case studies before people. And also look at cluster development. Dr. Koshi made a statement that India works in clusters, and if you go to every different place, there's an industry which is specialized, and how to work in clusters. First, we are going to identify many of these clusters and see how we can build modern design and modern way of doing the goods to bring that. Bali in Indonesia has done that remarkably well with getting designers to come and created a whole new industry for their handicrafts. And I think we need to do that to India too. Mr. Sunil Manjal is trying to do that in a very big way. We're going to work with him. So we had a very good discussion, and he came out with the agenda plan, and we are going to work with them to improve what we have been thinking and to come with an action agenda. And for the World Skill Council, our theme will be an agenda for action.